blood on your hands. You are guilty. You will always be guilty.
Was it worth it?
Nobody will love her now.
Can you remember what love feels like?
Look what happens to the thing she loves.
She destroys the thing she loves.
The Northmen tell how the gods mourned Baldur. His body was to be burnt on his ship, but they could not manage to push it into the sea and sent for a giantess to do it. She comes riding a wolf and has vipers for her reins. She pushes Baldur's ship into the sea with such force that the ground shakes and the rollers burst into flames. When Baldur's wife sees his body carried onto the ship, her heart bursts with grief, and she dies. She's put next to her husband, and the pyre is lit, sending the dead to hell. But even so, the gods cannot accept his death.
You squashed it, strangled it, flattened it.
The curse cannot be undone.
You're still alive and Dillian's dead. He doesn't deserve to be dead. How does that make you feel? Your curse has claimed Dillian. Poor Dillian. He didn't know. He was kind.
Years had passed since she left her father. She trained hard alongside her friend, Dillian. She saw things no one else could. Patterns. Shapes. Movement.
You couldn't see the darkness within.
An intuition that made her an exceptional warrior. Friendship turned to love. But the shadow of darkness never let her go, and she was caught between two worlds. That of Zinbel and her past, and Dillian, her future. Two realities tearing at her soul.
that she was strong.
Overcome with grief, the gods send Hermod to ride to Hel and ask Hela to let Baldur return home. All the gods are weeping, he says.
Do you remember?
Are they? Asks Hela. We shall see if he is truly missed. If everything in the world will weep for him, he shall go back to the gods. But if even one thing refuses, Baldur stays with me. The gods send messengers everywhere. Weep for Baldur! Weep him out of Hel! And everything wept. Men, beasts, earth, stone, trees, metal, everything. Except for a giantess they found in a cave. Baldur was never my friend, she says. Let Hel keep what she has. The Northmen say that the giantess must have been Loki in disguise.
Nobody will love her now.
Can you remember what love feels like?
Look what happens to the thing she loves.
She destroys the thing she loves.
Everything can be.
beauty. Was it worth it?
Dillian never much cared for the underworld, and looked dimly upon the druids, like her father, Zinbel. I guess he took after his father, a chieftain who believed nothing he couldn't see, and he happened to be blind. She felt safe in Dillian's arms, learned to see the world through his eyes. And slowly, the darkness that had bound her so tightly began to unravel.
You're going to fall, careful.
No, she's not. She's not. She's not.
She's listened to your father when you had the chance.
Why did you listen to him, girl?
His love has tortured you,
and it tortures them.
Dillian never much cared for the underworld, and looked dimly upon the druids, like her father, Zinbel. I guess he took after his father, a chieftain who believed nothing he couldn't see, and he happened to be blind. She felt safe in Dillian's arms, learned to see the world through his eyes. And slowly, the darkness that had bound her so tightly began to unravel.
You're going to fall, Kev.
No, she's not. She's not going to fall. She's strong. She's steady. She can do it. You can do it, Senua.
No! No! No!
Where's he gone?
It's your fault. He's disappeared. You've lost him to the sea. He's gone. You've lost him to the water. He's gone to the water.
Senua, your father cannot understand your darkness. He cannot see through your eyes. No one can. My own father was born blind. Doesn't have the faintest idea of what the night looks like. The word dark to him means as little as the word light. So someone is afraid of the dark. Should we fix them by taking away their sight? Would you give up the beautiful world that you, and only you, can see just to be rid of your nightmares? Or is this
killing
the price
you
pay
for
the gift you have?
They're taking your memories to torture you. They're taking
the gift that makes you so special
in one memory. Every time you remember, it disappears. They're going to take everything. They're not yours anymore. They're going to take everything you have.
The memories of ghosts.
And they belong to the gods
to protect you.
They're eating you from the inside. They want to kill your soul. They want to crush it. Body. They want your soul. They want your mind, and they're going to take it.
The memories were yours, but they're the gods now.
Nothing is yours anymore. Dillian's disappearing.
say that their all-father, Odin, gave his eye in exchange for a drink from Mimir's well, the Well of Wisdom. In blindness, there can be wisdom. Only by giving can you receive in return. For this reason, I give my life and pass on my stories of the Northmen to you, Senua.
Where am I? I can't see. Shh. Who's there?
Can you hear me? I'm right here. Can't you see me?
No. Help me.
Breathe slow.
It's the darkness.
Stay still. Empty your thoughts. Tell me what you feel.
A breeze.
Good. Then there is a way out.
I can't tell where it comes from.
Yes, you can.
The others, the voices, they've gone.
I'm still here.
It's so quiet, so dark.
It's okay. Listen to your own breath. Feel it rise and fall. Good. Be aware of everything you hear and feel. Let your senses guide you.
Can't go on. Lillian?
Find a way. I'm not leaving you here.
I think I'm somewhere else now. But the breeze has gone.
Use all of your senses. Let the world speak to you. What do you hear?
I hear water.
Go to it.
reached the water.
Good. That's your way out. Follow it upstream.
I'm so sorry. I thought I left this all behind.
Don't be sorry. It's not your fault.
He was right. It's inside of me. It won't let me go.
Senua, my father, he taught me that the hardest battles are fought in the mind, not the sword. You're no coward. Prove that to me in the warrior trials. This is just another battle. You can beat it.
This isn't your battle. You don't have to help me.
I want to. Besides, you are going to be a great warrior one day. We need people like you.
I'll do my best. There's a house. I don't know what's inside.
Don't be afraid.
Not following me.
Leave it behind and keep moving forwards.
There's more of them. I think they're moving.
They're breathing too fast.
I'm scared.
This is the sound of your breath. In and out. In and out. It will pass. You can do this, anyway.
I think I'm in a house. It stinks. Of death.
The darkness is testing you. But you are in control.
There's a well.
Don't turn back. You're getting close.
Delia. Help me.
She could spend hours, days even, trapped within herself, in the dark.
You see me?
Yes.
Your eyes were open, but you were gone.
And when it finally let her go, she could be anywhere. With no memory of how she got there.
When it comes for me, I have no power over it.
But here, for the first time, someone was there to help.
But I heard your voice. You brought me back.
You found your own way back. All you needed was a little help. A little hope.
Reforged, you will have Odin's blessing to walk a goddess into the halls of Helheim and challenge Hela as an equal.
So Dillion was helping me. And a sword will lead me to him. Like when we first met.
Dillion gave her the strength to pass the warrior trials, and she saw a way out. To leave her past behind, and become a warrior in Dillion's clan.
Go back. The sword is tainted by the gods of darkness. Leave it.
No. He left it here. He wants me to take it.
You will pay a price for this.
Years later, with Zinbel's parting words still haunting her, the darkness came back with a vengeance. A plague.
Dillion?
Everyone suffered.
My father was not supposed to die like this.
No.
Senua, the suffering you've caused.
This is your fault. You brought this plague to us. You have blood on your hands.
They're coming for you now.
They're coming.
Hold your heavy strike.
Hold it!
Hold your heavy strike. Hold your heavy strike. Unleash the sword.
She can't remember.
How does she focus?
The mirror.
Focus is coming back.
Finish this. End it now. She can ignore the pain.
You finished it.
Focus!
Waved through itself over the ones I loved. The ship broke up under them. The ship that had sailed from the land of shining fields. Their memorial stone is sacred. Come not here in the sun. Come not with a sword. Come not crying over a naked corpse. Come not with disturbed mind.